What's up, YouTube? This is Disposable 762, and we got us a new pistol. This is the Frontier model from Cimarron, chambered in 357 Magnum. This holster, if anybody's wondering, is George Feather, Tunston, Georgia. That's what it looks like. It's a nice leather holster, perfect for my new pistol. And just to show it kind of up close here a little bit. Got the 4¾-inch barrel. She's a pretty one. And these are going to be the first shots with it too, guys. So let's set up the range. Holding a fine bead at 6 o'clock. Still can't count. Missed one. And I know that's the old safety cowboy way of carrying the gun, was the load one, skip one, load four, and then the next cartridge or the next cylinder when the revolve cylinder went around was a empty chamber. So they would always carry their gun on empty chamber. This one, however, has a added feature that the old Colts, the 1873 Colts, never had, and I'm gonna show it to you right here in a minute. Huh, something happened there.
So what you have on this gun is this cylinder rod right here has another notch cut in on it, which makes it a little bit longer. But what it does, it opens up that hammer right there, protruding right there, so that hammer won't go all the way down. So, and to take it off safety, just push that in and push your hammer forward, and it's ready to go. See, now the hammer's back. Put it on safety, go to half cock, push the rod in, push that spring plunger rod in, and there you go. Now it's on safety. Then take it off, just push that in. Sometimes you gotta push the hammer forward, but didn't have to that time.
Nice gun, shoots pretty good. Might be my reloads too, but it's holding a fine bead is how I'm having to shoot it. And holding a fine bead, I hope you know what that means. So what I'm doing, I'm trying to use this camera here to show you what I mean by fine bead and coarse bead. Let's see if this is going to work.
Can't see the sight, but that's a fine bead right there. Pretty good shooting through the camera, huh? Take a little getting used to. Shoot the man. Camera's froze on me. There we go. Fine beat. That's it. So again, fine bead, coarse bead, fine bead, coarse bead, and then holding 6 o'clock. That right there, boom.
I do not recommend fanning a firearm for defensive purposes unless they're on top of you. Did not hit him, but scared him to death. Really enjoying this pistol. I've had Uberti black powder revolvers before, and he had the black powder revolvers, and I was worried about this gun, thinking it was going to be soft and the timing was going to be off of it and all that stuff, but that is not the case whatsoever. I ain't broke nothing yet, so maybe when I break something.
There you go, guys. Cimarron Frontier in 357 Magnum. I think it's a winner. I really do like it. One thing about the Cimarron. 1, 2, 3, 4. Hear the fourth click. 1, 2, 3, 4. So it is built as close probably to an original Colt that you can get. I don't know that for sure, but it isn't like the Rugers. It does have the firing pin on the hammer. And I know a lot of the replicas are like that, but this is the Frontier model again in 357. And love how it looks. Love that 4 3/4 inch barrel. Sounds good. It's tight. It's all good. It's about a $525 price tag. So, you know, maybe not the best quality, but it feels like it's good quality. So that got to mean something. Look how my hands are getting black from all that gunpowder residue. Ha! But I like the pistol. Might even start carrying it in the winter time here with my jacket, my coat. So, all right, guys, I'm disposable. 762. Remember, every knee shall bow and every tongue shall confess that Jesus Christ is Lord. And we're gone.